and new play. It's an old play and a new skin. Tom Dunn, our playwright, who is with us tonight, took an obscure play from 1000 AD written by Roswitha von Gandersheim. He took this play and played with it. And our wonderful cast of actors have also played with it and have been very inventive, and I'm sure you're going to enjoy their work. We have a change in the program. The man who was supposed to play Dulcitius, Michael Slobati, had an unfortunate family emergency, so he could not be here. So his role is being taken by the formidable John Mangiapane, who's also doing our director. Thank you, John, and bravo.
It is a farce.
It is a farce. So I do hope you'll all stay after the play and join the talk back, which will be led by Tom Dunn. This is the first ever public performance of his play, and he would love to have your feedback. So I hope you'll stay. Now, please turn off beepers and cell phones and enjoy the play. Places, people!
Roswitha, the king decided we should put this new thing of yours on.
On?
Yes, on. King Otto was very clear. He wanted to see people wearing old-looking clothes and saying the words you wrote for them to say. He told me it should be like a hanging or a bear baiting or a feast where everyone is singing and drinking and falling down. Do you understand? One of the king's wise men said that the ancient glorious Greeks, and even the filthy Romans, presented plays where lowlifes called actors would speak the words.
I've never heard of that kind of play. In the library, there's a manuscript of plays by a pagan named Terence. Those are to be read like a history or an astronomy, not given to lowlifes to butcher. All I did was take one of those pagan plays and make it modern. It was for the amusement of the nuns here at the Abbey. No one else.
Well, you know, King Otto, once he gets some new idea in his head, watch out.
Has King Otto even read my play?
After dinner, he practically ordered me to produce a copy. So I got Bertha the copy you're working on, and then 3 months later, voila! We have a play! We have actors, we have a place to do the play, and now we have you, our playwright. Hey, I like that. We have wheelwrights, and now a playwright.
Oh, Reverend Mother, I'm afraid the king is going to be very disappointed. I know nothing about how to put a play on.
Oh, this king of ours thinks of everything. Rosvita, the playwright, come meet your director. Rosvita, the playwright, come meet your director.
Oh, leave me alone. Can't you see I'm working?
What is a director?
One of the king's wise men came up with the name. It means man in charge.
Oh. I don't think that particular man in charge wants to work with this particular playwright.
And from what the wise man says, they apparently never will.
Huh?
When King Otto interviewed this guy, he made the comment that he preferred working with dead playwrights.
Oh, great.
Which, up until you came along, was pretty easy to do, working with dead playwrights.
Uh-huh. Reverend Mother, I've got an idea. How about letting me figure out how to put my play on? We can just let the director do whatever it is directors do.
Oh, no, my dear. That would never work. Playwrights can't direct their own plays.
Why not?
Well, I wouldn't know. The wise men or King Otto or someone figured this out, and that's just the way it is.
And always will be.
I know you well, Rosvita von Gandershein, and I think I'm detecting a bit of a change in attitude in you. Are you now thinking that maybe it will be all right for these people to present your play?
I have to say, I still have a lot of reservations, but
places, people, places!
Oh, I see, places, places!
Oh, I like this.
Oh, this is going to be fun.
Fun?
Music ready? Lights? Finish that set, would you? Is anybody listening to me? Focus, people, focus! Remember, you are all professionals. And here we go, scene one. This is our final dress. Remember, tomorrow night, it's the king. Oh, scene one. The pagan emperor enters in all of his splendid glory, accompanied by every pagan that we got.
Marvelous!
Where's the
emperor? Let's have the emperor! Yay!
What a way to start! What a way to go! Go, go,
oh
go!
I didn't quite know.
Isn't this exciting, my dear?
The pure and famous race to which you belong and your own rare beauty make it fitting that you should be wedded to the highest in the court. Thus we decree, making the condition that you should first promise to deny your Christ and sacrifice to the gods. Hey, there's nobody in here. There's nobody
virgins!
Here.
Virgins! Where are the virgins?
Wow.
You're doing fine after a great interest. Now stay focused. Don't drop your character. Stay focused. Virgins, are you? What did I tell you about focus? Is anybody listening to me? Take it again, Diocletian, from your line. Everybody know where we are.
The pure and famous race to which you belong and your own rare beauty make it fitting that you should be wedded to the highest in our court. Thus we decree, making the condition that you first promise to deny your Christ and sacrifice to the gods.
We... we beg you not to concern yourself about us, and it is useless to make preparations for our marriage. Nothing can make us deny that name which all should confess, or let our purity be stained.
What does this madness mean?
What sign of madness do you see in us?
It is clear enough.
In what way are we mad?
Is it not madness to give up practicing an ancient religion and run after this silly new Christian superstition?
You are bold to slander the majesty of Almighty God. It is dangerous!
Dangerous? To whom?
To you and to the state you rule!
The girl raves, raves! Take her away.
My sister does not rave. She is right.
This maiden seems even more violent than the other. Remove her also from our presence, and we shall question the third.
You will find her as rebellious and determined to resist.
Irena, you are the youngest in years. Show yourself the oldest in dignity.
Pray, tell me how.
Bow your head to the gods and set an example to your sisters. It may rebuke and save them.
Let those who wish to provoke the wrath of the Most High prostrate themselves before idols. I will not dishonor this head, which has been anointed with heavenly oil, by abasing it at the base of feet of images.
The worship of the gods does not bring dishonor to those who practice it, but, on the contrary, the greatest honor.
What could be more shameful baseness? What baser shame than to venerate slaves as if they were lords?
I do not ask you to worship slaves, but the gods of princes and the rulers of the earth.
A god who can be bought cheap in the marketplace. What is he but a slave?
Enough of this presumptuous chatter. The rack shall put an end to it.
That is what we desire. We ask nothing better than to suffer the most cruel tortures for the love of Christ.
Let these obstinate women, who dare to defy our authority, be laden with chains and thrown into a dungeon. Soldiers, I know. Let them be examined by Governor Dulcitius.
May I say something?
No, keep going, keep going, keep going. Great, Percy! Fantastic, fantastic!
I'm just
asking. Never mind. The lights.
I just keep going.
I'm the only one who gives notes here. You know that.
She does now.
Yes. Dulcitius, you're evil, you're mean, you're a pagan, you're a pervert. Soldiers, produce your prisoners.
The ones you wanted to see are here.
Ye gods, these girls are beautiful. What grace, what charm.
Perfect.
I am enraptured.
No wonder.
I am in love. Do you think that they will fall in love with me?
From what we know, you will have little success.
Why? Well, their faith is too strong.
A few sweet words will work wonders.
They despise flattery.
Then I shall woo in another fashion. Mm-hmm. With torture!
Oh, they would not care for that.
Well, what is to be done then?
That's for you to find out.
Lock them in the inner room, the pantry that is at the end of the passage where the pots and the pans are kept.
Why there?
I can visit them oftener, and my wife will think I'm just looking for a snack.
Ah, it shall be done.
Prisoners be doing at this hour of the night?
Oh, they pass the time singing hymns.
Let us approach comically.
Now you can hear their silver sweet voices even better.
Take your torches and guard the doors. I shall go in and enjoy myself in these lovely arms.
Enter. We will wait for you here.
Ha ha.